Welcome. In this short video, I'll try to show what's not so easy to show in a catalog or brochure. And today the focus is on our HVC high voltage continuity tester. You'll see how it is detecting and counting defects in the insulation, and also how the software is handling this, and what information you can get out of the software. The model we talk about today we call HVC 360 Flexible. It is a measuring head which can be combined with one of the three different sizes of electrodes we offer today. What's in common for them is they're using conductive brushes to cover the full surface of the wire. Since the introduction in 2007, it has been an important tool for securing the quality for manufacture of enamelled wire and the user of wire as well. As mentioned, we use a set of brushes to obtain a test zone of the 360 degrees around the wire. The first model is the standard model, which is able to handle wire dimensions from 5 microns up to 2.5 millimeters. The second model is for heavier wire and have a dimension range from 0.5 to 26 millimeters. Note the brushes is covering also the corner, which can be a problem to achieve in other systems. Let's try to see how it looks like when an error is in the insulation is passing the test zone of the brushes. It is easy to see that the high voltage is making a small light arc when the current starts flowing from the brushes to the conductor. In the picture you can see each electrode a small blue dot. Due to the high tension per square millimeter in the brushes do not even need to touch the wire for being able to count. Lately we have made a third model special for testing hairpins, mainly being used in the automotive industry. The continuity tester is testing each hairpin, and the tester can be a part of the production line, which secures that each item is being tested, and the item which failed is sorted away automatically. Let's take a look at the measuring principle behind it. A part of the measuring head is a high voltage generator, which is operating from 350 to 6 kV. The inner conductor is connected to ground, and now we measure continuously the current flowing from the brushes towards ground. Due to the insulation, the current can't only flow in cases of defects in the insulation. The current being measured is sent to the connected processor module. When the error in the insulation is passing the measuring head, the processor module is counting it and gives an alarm in case of the number of errors exceeding the limit being set in the software. This figure shows what's happened with the current flowing the brushes to ground. When the insulation is okay, no current is flowing. At the moment, an error such as a crack or pinhole, the current goes to its maximum. A special feature we have built in the HVC is the ability to have two sensitivities. It means we have two counters which can count errors in two different levels. The benefit for having a detector with higher sensitivity, which we call threshold 2, is to get the possibility to find and count also the weak spots in the insulation. Often if something is happening and the number of errors suddenly increases and being detected by a normal counter, detector 1, the number of errors counted by the more sensitive detector 2 for a longer time already has been counted. From this screen dump taken from an installation, it is clear that the number of errors being detected by the more sensitive threshold 2 has exceeded a limit for many test lengths, and then suddenly the more serious error is coming afterwards. By using this feature, we have a pre-warning signal, an indication that something will occur and action can be taken by the operator. Please note, to be able to use threshold 2, a certain speed of the line is needed. I better remember to say that the high voltage sounds dangerous, but only combined with current. The system is safe to use and without dangers for the operator, because the maximum current is limited to 100 microamps. Let's take a look at the screen. A high number of lines can be monitored at the same time on the PC screen. 1, 4, 8 lines, etc. The overall status of each line is displayed by the background. It is easy even from long distance for the operator to get a good overview. Let's take a look at the histogram for one single line. On the y-axis we have the number of error per test length. On top, the number of meter per test length being set in the software is shown, and the test voltage. The x-axis shows the number of test lengths, and it's being updated for each new test length. To the right, the total meter being produced on the reel so far is shown. In the histogram, we can see the first 9 test lengths, and in the test length number 4, the system has detected 4 errors, and in test length number 7, it has been found 3 errors. The alarm and warning limits being set in the software is shown as a line across the histogram. We can see the error being detected and how the background changes status when limits are exceeded. On the processor module, the output for warning and alarm is being activated, so an acoustic alarm or light tower can be turned on. A question I often been asked is, what happens if the PC goes down or need upgrades? Will it lose all the data? Normally the data is stored on a hard disk, locally on a central SQL server. But what happens if at the moment the PC does not work? How does it collect data? The processor module has a buffer built in. It's not unlimited, but typical a half an hour is not a problem, and the data will be buffered, and at the moment the PC is up again, all the collected data is transferred and will be shown on the PC again. Finally, I would like to tell a bit about the in and output signal. Communication between the processor module and the PC is handled by USB or RS232 to RS485. And all modules can be connected in daisy chain, and the PC can handle up to 99 processor modules. All in and outputs are optical and isolated. The outputs use an open collector, which makes it possible to connect them in parallel. The alarm and warning signal is changing status for around 200 milliseconds. And by using a latching relay, the alarm and warning stays until it's being reset by the operator. The system needs to know the speed, and this is done by sourcing pulses to the processor module. The pulse can be supplied from a proximity switch mounted on a pulley, or it can also come from a PLC. In the software, the meter or fraction of meters between each pulse is configured. When a wheel of wire is completed, a signal for the information is needed. At wheel change, the complete set of data for the wheel or spool is being stored and can later on be sent to a customer or viewed for inspection. Thank you from us at DSE Test Solutions for watching, and I hope you will go to our webpage or contact us in case of question or if you need further information.